word, sir? Only tuppence a bag.
I would take it a great favor if you would feed them for me. Because his scheme was hollow. It had no product, it had no substance, it had no meaning outside the walls of a bank. Oh yes, he told me about assets, profits, and growth, but there wasn't a word about people. I know that if a man puts any value on real life, then as far as you're concerned, he's a washout. But I'm afraid I do, gentlemen. In short, George Banks Esquire has rediscovered the human race. I do apologize for ruining the bank. But I do not apologize for understanding that there are more important things in life than making money. Ruining the bank. Ruining the bank. Ruining the bank. My dear chap, what are you talking about? You saved our bacon. Well, haven't you heard? Van Hustler's scheme has ruined our rival. You've kept us out of the nastiest scandals, well, since records began. We don't want your apologies, we're offering ours. Oh my word. And another thing. Do you remember offering a loan to a fellow named Northbrook? Well, he's repaying it, opening two new factories with the percentage that you negotiated. We look set to make a fortune. My word. Well, that's just it. We very much hope you might tell us how you did it. Just give us the word, be quite all right with us. Give you the word. Give you the word. I'll give you the word, all right. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious! Even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, the Lord is on the ghost. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious! Oh, sir, thank you. Now, thanks.
Wait! Forgive him, it's not his fault. It's because of his nanny, Miss Andrew.
The Holy Terror! Well, she's taught me everything I know. Then now's your chance to forget it.
That's right. If you want to fight, you come to the right woman.
It's all right, darling. It's all right. I haven't lost money at all. In fact, I've made the bank a fortune.
Really?
Clerks. Gentlemen, if...
Madam.
If you please, we still have some business to conduct. Ah. Well. Banks, George. By way of recompense, we'd like to offer you a job as senior manager with a salary at double.
Exactly how much has he made for you?
Triple. Quadruple, your present rate.
Close your mouth, George. We are not a codfish.
Well, I accept. But you must understand one thing. From now on, my family comes first. Agreed. I'm afraid I've underestimated you. How can you forgive me?
How can you ask?
It was selfish of me to keep you off the stage. You'll want to go back, and I won't mind if you do.
No, I loved it, but I found a job I'd much rather prefer, and it's going to keep me extremely busy for a very long time.
Anything can happen if you let it. Things you thought impossible will still seem certain. Now at first in case of damage, see the world all upside downish, turn it on its head and pirouette it.